Every time I get to this video and I say it's that time of the month again, I think it's something about having a period. It's not. We're gonna go over what I'm loving this month. Hi friends, I have a video for you today that is all about the things that I've been loving this month, but it's also about the things that I have not been loving. I had quite a few fails this month, so I'm gonna get into that so that you guys can see. But first, if you're new to my channel, I wanna say a special welcome to you. I hope that you do consider subscribing and don't forget to hit the bell icon because that is how you get notified of future videos that I have. And of course, to all of my faithful followers, I wanna say thank you so much for all of your support. We are, as of this recording, we're about 500 away from 50,000, and I could not be happier about that number. It's taken me a while to get there, but it's been a fun ride. Over 400 videos, 400 and like 70 or some videos. So if you want to know about anything beauty in the past, type in my name and then type in the subject. So Mrs. Melissa M hair, Mrs. Melissa M skincare routine, anything like that that you want to know about, that you're wondering about in my past videos, then you can be able to get it that way in the search. So let's get into what I was loving in the month of October so that you can see the favorites and the fails right now. So we're going to start with some new skincare that I did talk about earlier in the month that has really impressed me and that I feel like is making a big change. These are two products right here. This is an LED light handheld device. It is red and blue, both. And then this is green tea fresh toner from Isntree. Isntree is a brand that I've kind of fallen in love with. I've talked about them a lot and their products, but the green tea in conjunction with this LED light, by the way, this is called Light, L-Y-T-E. It basically is for skin rejuvenation and for helping to boost collagen, for helping to reduce fine lines and wrinkles and all those fun things that we get when we're over 40. But why I really like the green tea toner is that this will boost the efficiency or the efficacy, how well it does, 10 times. And that's a study that I learned off of Penny from Penn Smith Skincare's channel. But for me, this really is doing a great job, the two of them together. I pay a lot of extra attention around my lip area because I have such bad vertical lines around my lip area. And so I do this on both sides. And even the marionette lines right here are just so diminished. I can't believe it. I'm worried about my forehead lines too, but those are like deep wrinkles from like raising my eyebrows or squinting or that kind of thing. So I'm gonna have a harder time dealing with those, but these right around here, I just felt like were showing my age really bad around my lips. So using this, I was getting good results, but as soon as I introduced the green tea toner and used it 20 minutes before, like the study said, you wanna put it on fresh, dry, clean skin, let it dry, and then go ahead and use this like you would normally do. And this takes, I think the timer on this is about 3 to 10 minutes in each spot. So I just kind of do it when I'm like at the end of the day, we're watching TV or I'm reading or something, and I just move it around a lot. I wish I could afford one of those big ones that's the mask over the head. I can't afford that. It's like $450 or something like that. But I really do enjoy this, and I feel like it's making a huge difference in my skin and the lines and wrinkles. And yeah, I can recommend both of those and really loving that this month. So something else that I've really been loving this month is from City Beauty, and this is the Blue Defense Hydrogel. This is a really good moisturizer, but you do need something over top of it that is occlusive. This says that it can give up to 72 hours of moisture. I live in a really, really dry, dry climate. And in the winter when all this heat is on and it is dry outside anyway, I mean, we're talking like 5-8% outside, you turn the heat on inside, there's no percent of humidity. By the way, I do have behind me today, and you can see that, that is a humidifier, a standing humidifier that I will make sure I link below. This holds 2 gallons of water, and I have been loving using that. It's on my husband's side of the bed because he has really bad sinus problems, but I'll make sure that I link that for you. And here's Ollie, he just barked and wanted to see his mom. So that humidifier is a really great humidifier for my husband because he has really bad allergies, really bad sinuses, and he just has a problem with having sinus headaches every morning. I can put that in our room as soon as the weather starts to cool off, and we'll have it running morning and night, and it helps both of us so much with our sinuses. And for me, it's great for dry skin because I have super dry skin, like I just said. Now I'm gonna show you Ollie. He's getting so dark. He's dark and he's turning a little bit red, and he's so big. And I love this dog. He's just, he has to show up in every video. So he's wanting to go away and lay down and take a nap. So bye, Ollie. Love you. Bye, guys. So I was talking about the City Beauty Blue Defense Hydro Gel. Now, this is a fairly thick product. You know what it reminds me of is the Clinique Moisture Surge. I'm enjoying this to go underneath my other creams to hold a ton of moisture throughout the day. So I can recommend that one, but I know that City Beauty is a little bit expensive. They sent me all these products. I'm loving these products, but I do realize they're expensive. So please, please, please get on their email list because they have sales all the time. I mean, I'm getting a sale thing every single week for something that they have in their line. And then I want to talk about Good Molecules and their overnight exfoliating treatment. If you have ever gotten a sample, or if you love Sunday Riley's Good Jeans, you put that on at night and in the morning your skin looks brighter and smoother. The same thing with this. That's the same exact product, just a whole heck of a lot cheaper. And that's basically what the Sunday Riley Good Jeans has, and a few other questionable ingredients in that one, but there's such good ingredients in this one, including the lactic acid. So you're getting that little bit of cellular turnover. If you have a strong reaction to this, meaning that if you feel like you're super irritated the next day, or if it's really stinging as you put it on, that should go away in a couple of minutes. If it doesn't, go ahead and treat this like a mask on your skin. Put on a layer of it and then let it sit on your skin for 10 to 20 minutes and then rinse it off with water and then move on with the rest of your skincare. And you're gonna find that you still have the benefits of it, but if you have sensitive skin, it's gonna work better for you because it's not sitting on there all night long. Little tip there. That's what I do when I'm having a really bad peel from my retin-A. I'll use this especially on the parts that I get really bad. And this is usually the part I get really, really flaky and really junky with. But I'll use this and then I'll rinse it off and then go on with my other skincare. And my skin is really livened up. And that's what I really like about it. It really does help the dullness and take off that dead skin layer so the pretty new skin can shine through. And that's a bonus for me. The Neck Elasticity Catalyst from Niod is such a good product. I've really fallen in love with this month. I basically just put it on my neck area. I don't even really put it on my décolleté. So neck area to about a third of the way up my cheeks right here to help with that sagging skin that you get so bad when as you age. I do anyway. The delivery system isn't great on this, but I have had several of you say that the double size of this is in a metal tube that you can squeeze. So you might think about that if you don't like the delivery system on this. However, I just store mine upside down and then you can just, you know, dot it on your finger. It's a very thick consistency. It's the consistency of honey. I said this before, but it doesn't go on like honey. It's not thick like that. It has that little emollience that honey does, that little, you know, it looks like it, and you put it on there and you start to rub it in, you're thinking, this is gonna be too thick, but it rubs into your skin so quickly, and that's what I love about it. And as I'm working it in, my skin starts to feel like silk, and I think that is so great. I really have been loving this. I feel like it's doing a really good job of helping my gel achieve a more lifted look around my face right here. So it's something that I'm gonna repurchase, I know I am, but this jar, I use this every morning, every night, and I have hardly made a dent in this jar because you don't need a lot. But now that I feel my hand after rubbing that in, talking to you guys, it's super silky and it just feels so good. And it's just one of those products that I know it's sinking in instead of sitting on the top like so many neck creams do, where it balls up after a few minutes and you're like, oh, this is gross. But this stuff is really sinking in, so I know that you're getting the benefits of it. I really do like it a lot. And I would recommend that you go through Skin Store to buy this. I'll make sure I link it below. But Skin Store always has sales. So again, get on their email list and you're gonna get a great sale on this. Now, a couple of skincare items that I'm really not impressed with at all. So the Derma E Firming DMAE Serum with Alpha Lipoic Acid. This is okay. I don't like the fragrance of this. It has quite a strong fragrance, and I'm not a fragrance person in my skincare. I want my skincare to just be just skincare. And it does have like a lavender fragrance to it. But the product itself, I used about half of it. So I'm about halfway down here. The product itself, again, I don't feel like it sank in and did that much for my skin. This product is supposed to be firming. DMAE is supposed to have that same effect that's going to lift your skin and give you a firmer, more youthful look to it. I don't feel like that's done that. Even after using it halfway, whereas the Niod, I feel like I'm seeing results very quickly. So this is one that I would pass on if I were you. It's not one that is really doing much for my neck at all. And also I got this last month, it might've been the month before, but anyway, this is the Strivectin lip treatment. You have what is supposed to be a serum on one side that you paint around your lips. And then this is supposed to be a lip plumping gel or a lip pump plumping gloss that you use. I've used this whole tube up and I've seen nothing different in my lips. And it wasn't until I started using that LED light around them that I started to notice changes. So this is one that I would tell you to pass on as well. Okay, so YSL gifted me this foundation through the Octoly Network. Let me read for you guys. The YSL Touche Éclat All-in-One Glow Oxtenoxate, something like that. Throw it up on the screen here. I murdered that one. Sunscreen. Broad spectrum SPF of 23, fresh, dewy makeup, natural, medium coverage, long-lasting hydration, and oil-free. Okay, I do feel like it's all of those things. This is a terrible color for me. Horrible color. BR30. I don't know exactly what color that is, but it's a bad color for me. I do have another foundation from them, which is the All Hours Foundation. Again, that has the same sunscreen in it. And this one is color BR20. So BR20 is super duper light for me. This is a heavier foundation. And then the YSL Touche Éclat, the All-in-One Glow Foundation, is a little bit too glowy dewy. So even though I do have very dry skin, I was finding that this was slipping around a lot. But I'll tell you what, if I put these two together, which I'm not a huge fan of this foundation at all either, the All Hours, but putting the two together, not only does it mix to be my perfect color, it mixes to be my perfect foundation. It's what I have on today. It's what I've been wearing for a week. I know that you're not going to go out and buy both of these foundations, but if you do have either one of these foundations and you found that it doesn't work on its own, consider mixing the All Hours one with a more dewy foundation, and then consider mixing the All-in-One Glow with a more matte foundation, and you're probably going to love them. Something that is a new release that I'm really excited about, and this will probably go into a get ready with me so you guys can see. These are the new putty blushes from e.l.f. that they are expanding their putty line. They did the eye primers, which I was not a fan of, but these blushes I am really liking. Okay, so this one I have on today, and then the other one that is a little bit more muted, I wore this a couple of days ago. So these do not have colors written on the jar anywhere, but I will make sure that I put them up for you guys. This one is such a pretty pink color, and it just goes across your skin so nicely. It has that same slip that the putty primer does, but it still has the property in it that helps it to stick a long time on the skin. So I just, you know, buff this out with my finger or with a stipple brush, and it just looks so good on the skin. I do have a lot of colors, and you definitely can build these up. So if you're a woman that has deeper skin, you're going to be able to build and build and build until you get what you want to on there. And they do have a couple colors that are even deeper than these colors. So these are the two that I got. Really enjoying both of them. I think that they are just so pretty on the skin. If you're somebody that has aging skin and blush is just not your thing, try a cream blush. I think that you will be pleasantly surprised on how pretty they are on the skin. And then if you want to, you can layer a little bit of a luminous one on top of it for a multi-dimensional look on your cheeks. So, you know, give these a try. They're not very expensive, and I am in love with them. I just think that it's a great product that e.l.f.'s come out with. Couple products that I'm not really in love with. Nobody throws stones, but this Charlotte Tilbury blush, it's okay. It is not my favorite blush. There is supposed to be a two-tone thing in here, but for this one in particular, there's not a really big difference in the tones here. So This is like a pink in the middle and then a peachy pink on the outside. I don't know if I'm completely sold on these. I really like her powder and I like some of her other products, but this one is just one that it's like, it's a blush. It's not anything great. It's kind of pretty. I'm not saying that it's not. You can swirl around here and you get something, you know, that you're gonna, it's really light. That's for sure. This is the e.l.f. blush. Look how light that is. I don't feel like it stays around a long time. So I'm not somebody that's going to say, go out and spend a ton of money on a blush like this. Because I just feel like this is a blush that you can get a better version of at the drugstore. So one of those things I'm just like, eh, not really. And then the new Lash Freak from Urban Decay. I really had an affinity to this at the beginning because I guess maybe I didn't know what I was doing. This has the most weird bristles. I just don't even get what they're trying to do here. I don't get what this side is supposed to do. This is the only side that you can comb out lashes with. And then it does have a few little gripper things right there on the bottom of it. So the brush is weird. It gets out a lot of product and then you kind of have to just run the product down and really get the product off. And I do have it on today, but I had to be really careful and really work with this. And when I'm putting on mascara, even though I do usually rub off my wand a little bit, I don't want to have to fuss with it so much that I, you know, get clumps and then have to separate it with the wand and keep worrying about that. I want it to build on itself. I want it to be beautiful just without a ton of work. And this is not a mascara that you can do that with. This takes more work than I'm willing to put into it. And the other thing about it is that when you're paying this kind of price for this for a high-end mascara, I want it to just be something that is simple and it just goes on effortlessly. That's not this mascara. And so, then I know that so many of you know what Sydney Grace is, who Sydney Grace, their company is. They are a higher end eyeshadow company that, oh my gosh, they make the most gorgeous eyeshadows in the pans, the pressed eyeshadows. But they also make a bunch of other products. And this month I tried out their liquid eyeshadows. These are intensely beautiful. I am in love with these. I will make sure that I put up on the screen what these are. This first one is like a champagne silver color. And you can see how intense that is. I mean, I put way too much on there. You don't need that much. What I do is I put a tiny bit on the back of my hand and then I'll go ahead and just dip my brush into it and do it that way. I don't do my fingers on this one because it can get a little bit messy. And then this one is like a violet color. This is so beautiful, both of these. Look at those. Look at the shine on them and the reflect on them. Oh my goodness. It's just one of those eyeshadows that really performs well. Now, I have tried so many liquid eyeshadows, Stila, Urban Decay. I've tried a ton of them from the drugstore, NYX, Essence, L'Oreal. I've tried so many, but I have never had eyeshadows perform like this. Now, they are a wet eyeshadow. It's a liquid eyeshadow. So you're going to have to kind of build it up in very thin layers in order for it not to transfer on your upper lid. And it just gives the most beautiful, intense color, and I'm in love with it. Hi, Smuckers. You're back. How you doing? You doing good? Anyway, I'm in love with these. And for the price, I think that this is great. You get way more product in here than you do from all those companies that offer liquid eyeshadows. And the payoff, oh my gosh, the payoff is fantastic. So I'm in love with those. And then lastly, do y'all know who Sabrina is? Sabrina. She is the most beautiful YouTuber here. This woman has a gorgeous soul and a gorgeous spirit around her. I love her. She's just amazing. So Sabrina did a fall lipstick video where she gave recommendations for the drugstore. I had to go out and immediately buy some that she recommended. So this is a L'Oreal duo that she wore in the video. And I do kind of have it modified a little bit on my lips today. But this is the color Riche Matte lip liner, and this one is in Curiosity Killed the Matte, and this is a very burgundy color. It's got some purple in it. It's a very deep color, and what she did was she lined her lips with this and then really feathered it out and, you know, kind of muted it a little bit so you can see the difference. I've kind of muted it on the bottom, and then the top is just the really stark line of it. And then over top of it, she did their lip crayon, which this one is the color No Fig Deal. They have the funniest names. Okay, so this coupled with this. Okay, there it is together right there. So that's a really stark line of it. But you kind of mix these together and feather them together, and you can get just the prettiest fall color that is like a really bright fuchsia, but it's so pretty on the lip. I will go ahead and just put a little bit more on here so you can see how nice it is. I do have a gloss over top of it, but this is a pretty, pretty color. Just a beautiful fuchsia color. And it just is one of those that I fell in love with as soon as I saw it on her. And then the duo together, it just is like magic. It's just really, really pretty. So you get an ombre look on your lips. So I've been loving that as well. I hope that you did enjoy all of these. What was your favorite for the month of October? Did you pick up anything new, or were you just going back to your own stash and finding things that you loved? I would love to hear that from you in the comment section. Please give this video a thumbs up on your way out of here, everyone. I would really appreciate that. I hope everybody is having a great week. And please stay happy, stay healthy, stay sanitized. And I will catch you guys all in my next video. Love you much. Bye-bye.